Hello friends, and welcome to this tutorial on how to implement party and supplied item filter during billing in MargiRP 9+. This feature helps in maintaining better customer relationship. When you go on sale bill window and switch to the ledgers window, you'll find a filter icon right here. You can either click here or press the Alt plus S key. So these are some options according to which you can filter parties. First is party not visited. Means I want to filter only those parties who have not visited me since a while, means to whom sale is not done. The first field is not sold in last 30 days. 30 days is set by default. You can change that from control room. So here it's defined not sold in last 30 days, but sold in next 30 days. Means I want the software to filter only those parties who have not visited me since the last 30 days, but used to visit me before these 30 days. So here you define how many days back. Like today is 30th September 2016. So 30 days back will be 31st August 2016. So suppose I set this to 0 and let this be 30. So software will filter those parties who have not visited me between these days. The next field is but sold in next, suppose 30 days. So 30 days before 31st August 2016 is 1 August 2016. So software will filter those parties who used to visit us, means whose sale bill used to be generated between these days. Summarizing, we can say that I want to filter those parties who have not visited me since the last 30 days from the current date, but used to visit me 30 days before these 30 days. Now let's enter. So the software has filtered this party. So this is the name of the party, Ahuja, Ahuja Medicine Center. This is the balance from this party's ledger. And here it shows the amount of sale that was made to this party. The benefit of this feature is that you will come to know that which all parties are not dealing with you anymore, but used to deal with you. So you can contact them and know the reason and increase your relationship with your customer. You can even take a printout of this report by pressing Alt plus P key and select whether you want to print contact information of parties or do not want to print contact information of parties. Next option is party sales decrease. Through this report, you can take a look at the parties whose sale has decreased. So first is sale decrease in the last 30 days. We'll keep this 30. Means I want to take a look at the list of parties whose sale is less in the last 30 days compared to the sale done to them before the last 30 days. Like today is 30th September 2016. 30 days before 30th September 2016 was 31st August 2016. And 30 days before 31st August 2016 was 1st August 2016. So let's take the following example. On 9th September 2016, sale of Rs. 100 was done to Narala Pharma. And on 29th August 2016, sale of Rs. 5000 was done to Narala Pharma. So the sale has decreased. Means between these days, the sale was 5000 rupees. And between these days, the sale was Rs. 100. So the sale has decreased. Now let's enter. So here it shows the list of parties and it also shows the percentage of decreased sale. Means the sale has decreased to -97%. So here it shows current sale, means this month's sale or past 30 days sale, that is 107 rupees. And then it shows the old sale, means last month's sale or last to last 30 days sale. Also you can set minimum sale amount. Means you can set that minimum how much amount sale do you want to see. I want to see more than 100 rupees sale, so I will define here 100. And you can also set percentage. Like if I want to take a look at the parties whose sale has decreased to -33%, so I will type here -33. And then software will show the list of those parties accordingly. In the same way, you can see party sale increase. Means you can take a look at those parties whose sale has increased. So here these are the parties whose current sale is more than the old sale and the sale has increased by this much percentage. Next option is limit cross. Means you can filter those parties who have crossed their credit limit. So these are the customers who have crossed their credit limit. Down here it shows the credit limit that we have set for this party in his ledger's other details, and this is the balance of this customer. And since it is exceeding the credit limit which we have set, that's why this customer's ledger is shown here. Then the number of bills are shown whose total bill amount has exceeded the credit limit. And then is days, which shows how many days back the bill was created. The last filter is top ordering parties. The first option is sale basis in last 30 days. Then is sale more than suppose 200 and bills more than suppose 2. Means I want the software to filter those parties to whom sale of more than 200 rupees is done and more than 2 bills have been generated for them in the last 30 days. So here it is. This is my party, his balance. His balance amount is 5829 and the total sale amount is 5262. And the number of bills generated for him are 2. So friends, in this way we learned about some very useful party filter options in Marc software. Now let me show you supplied items filter option. Through this option you can view a list of only those items which have been supplied to your parties before. And this list can be viewed party wise. So let me show you how. While billing, you'll select a ledger. And on the items window, you will press Alt plus S key or Shift plus question mark key. Or you can click on this filter icon. So a list of those items will be shown which have been supplied to the customer before. Means these items have been purchased by the customer before. So friends, in this way we learned about how to implement party and supplied item filter in Marc software. Thanks for watching.